Hi, I'm Clare Stokolosa. I'm an artist. I live in New York City. I'm a practicing artist. My studio is in Long Island City. I have always been an artist since I'm a little girl, making little sculptures out of dough at my mother's kitchen table. And I think I was tracked that way as a kid. You know, I needed glasses and I was good at art. I remember my first grade teacher saying that. I taught art and I was very lucky to have a career where I was teaching and practicing my art. And now I am a full-time artist. I show internationally and I'm very interested in people and interaction and travel. Right now we're uptown at Boricua College in Manhattan, and this is my show of New York City Faces, which is a series of work of the subway, the L train, the railroad, and it's basically documentation of people and how we interact. I grew up in Astoria, born and raised in Astoria, and then moved to Sunnyside. I grew up on 33rd off of Broadway, and the L train was right on 31st Street in Broadway. I remember it very well. I also remembered it was a boundary on my neighborhood, so if I was going to cross the L, I was kind of leaving the neighborhood. I could go, but I had to tell my parents. I lived right off of Broadway and right on 33rd, which led to Grand Central. And then if you went left, it led to the Tribo Bridge. So, you know, I was in the hub on the first floor, listening to the cars go by, listening to the train, listening, you know, it was right off of Broadway with all the stores. So yes, it was natural. It was natural to me. Some of those sounds were just so familiar, like the train pulling in. It was different than it gearing up. I guess eventually that sound's gonna change and they'll make the trains quieter, but it gearing up and pulling out of the station and it coming to a break. The sounds of people passing my window, the hustle and bustle of people coming down and watching people come off the train, because I used to go and wait for my mom to come home from work. You know, I would miss her and just watch people come down the train, and there was the candy store with the newspapers outside. It's still there. And people would just like throw their money, you know, the 10 cents or nickel into the box, the cigar box, and pick up the paper from outside. You know, it was a different way of life. And just like people and talking and chattering, and that background talking, that background sound is normal for me. It doesn't bother me. Sometimes I like real quiet, but I can find quiet within myself. I find it in my art. I always sketched. I went to art and design. We were taught to sketch on the train. People in different places. I do a lot of people in the piazzas in Italy. Public spaces really interest me. Very interested in how people interact. They can be both private and public, and how we coexist. For this series, I was traveling uptown, actually to Boricua College. I was teaching an art history class, and I started on the railroad. I can take the train, a bus and a train to go to the 7, but I took the railroad to Penn, and then I would get the 1, or I'd go to my studio. I was in a different location and jump on the 7 train. And I just noticed everyone, and it depended on the time of day, but everyone was on their phone. No one was talking to each other. Very few people were reading hardcover books, paper books. They may have been reading on their phone. And I just saw this phenomenon. People weren't looking, people weren't interacting. And I really started this as an anthropological study. I said, I'm not going to take out my phone. I always carry my sketch pad. It's very rare I don't have it, so I took it out. And I just sketched, and no one was looking at me because everyone was looking at their phone. And I noticed people were doing different things during different times of the week. So as the week would go on, maybe towards a Friday, they were sleeping more, they weren't on their phones as much. On Mondays, everyone had their phones out, and they were like looking down. So they may have been talking to people, but they were not interacting with each other. But, you know, there was some type of interaction, of course, and I just kind of, I like to document it. So that's really how this series of New York City Faces started. I use a pen. I use different markers, depending. Black markers, permanent markers, and the alcohol markers, there are different types. And I like using a marker because I'm not paying so much attention to the drawing. I'm just kind of looking, observing, have my hand on the page with my marker, and I'm sketching. And I just wanted to capture it. I didn't really want to go back and make it perfect. It was just about capturing a mood, a moment, because people come and go. So some of the drawings took longer, some were quick, depending on when someone was getting off the train or when I decided to start drawing them or if someone walked in front of them. So you have all these different happenings that affect the drawing. I sketch, I don't want to say randomly, but I'll have my pad and I'll look around and I'll decide, I'll have a feeling. I don't want to be that obvious, but I might just see someone and want to capture them. They might have a certain character to them, or just something about them that I want to get down on the page, or I'm just moved by it, you know, a person, where I am, where they're seated, how they're dressed, and I start sketching. And sometimes someone will get off the train at a certain stop and someone else will get on, or someone will come and stand in front of another person, I'll add them, or I'll just have their feet in it. Or I'll start with someone's feet and add another one. So I just keep going. I wait. Sometimes I have to wait. I have to feel the moment, but then I'll just sketch. I have one painting here that I didn't sketch until the young woman was about to get off the train, but I was really wanted to draw her. She seemed like very kind of delicate and just kind of bird-like. I mean, in like a kind of fragile and delicate, and she was sitting there, but I didn't want her to see me drawing her. So I just was kind of looking at her in a non-obvious way. And I said, okay, I'm gonna draw her. And I started drawing her and she got off the train. But because I was looking at her for so long, I was able to capture it and capture her quickly and capture like the person next to her. So that worked out. So some of the drawings I might spend a little longer on, and some it depends on when they're on and off the train. But that is just part one of this whole process. I collect a bunch of sketches. I didn't know I was going to have the series of paintings that are these big, huge paintings. That came to me actually when I was working on another series. But I had a collection of drawings. I continued to draw and I had all these drawings. And I was looking through one of my sketch pads and somehow I just thought to myself, I want to do something with these. I have this feeling. I know what I want to do. I investigated a little bit. I found a way to enlarge them onto watercolor paper and keep the process, keep that richness of the drawing. Well, richness may not be the correct word, the spontaneity. I didn't want to correct it. That's why I didn't want to get wrapped up in the actual drawing. I just wanted to capture the moment. So how could I do that? I can draw large. I've been painting my whole life and drawing. I decided to enlarge them onto prints. So it's a black line that I have printed onto a large watercolor paper. And the size was very precise. I did a lot of research on what size I wanted it to be. Then I did an entire series. And then in my studio, I paint them. So the process is really over time. And once I get rolling, It could take me several months to complete one. But once I'm in the mood or I have that palette going and I'm feeling it, I could stay up all night. I could go in very early in the morning. I could spend a day on a piece. I'll just stay in my studio and paint and get three of them done. In some ways, it's harder to sketch on the L because you have that light and it changes. So you have the shadow and the reflections as it's going, and it changes as it may pass a building. So you have that constant change of light where if you're underground, it's a constant. However, the L affects, it doesn't stop me from drawing on the L. I like drawing on the 7, you get a nice light. Usually when I'm drawing on the L, I'm drawing someone sitting kind of by the door because you don't have that light right behind them as much. They kind of have the wall next to the door that's blocking it a little bit from going in and out. But what affects me with the L is the light and growing up next to the L. I am fascinated with light, and I believe it affects my palette when I paint. I believe it affects the fact that I like to paint in watercolor. I paint in acrylic and oil also, but I love something about that watercolor, the translucence. And growing up and being by the L, and even the sounds, everything about it, even with this series, that constant, that sleepiness, that in and out, waiting on the base of the steps and seeing the light or hearing the train come to a stop and the screech of it, which wasn't a screech to me, and just seeing the pattern. These are all terms and all things that relate to art. The pattern, the light, the changing of the light, even sound. We want to capture that, I do as an artist, in my work. And that the light, the changing of the light, the shadows, I bring that, which I used to watch as the trains would pull into a station and pull out, you would see the slats and how the light would change and hear the sound of it and just hear that like rumbling noise as it pulls out. And I believe that influences my painting. I think if we really observe how we interact in New York City, on the trains, on the L, waiting on a platform, we could really learn how to use that to live in a peaceful world. You know, that's really what my goal is, you know. That's a huge goal, but I think it's very possible. And I'm also have an expansion of this show where I am working on a series that go with these paintings, and they're in pastel, where I pick objects that people have in their possession and make that a drawing of them on newspaper. So I use the Times, I use different newspapers. I like using the Times because I can fold it like in different shapes and then frame them. And I'd like to see an interactive part of this. I have a whole prospectus written up. I want people's reactions. I want people's stories. I want people to respond. So I'd like to have a public platform where people can respond to the work and tell their story about their experience on the trip. Okay.